Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 13, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 6, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Translation. I shall now explain the noble, knowing which you will face the eternal. This is the kingdom, and it is subordinate to me. It is called Brahman, the spirit, and lies beyond the cause and effect of this material world.
Jasaika nishasita kalma khavalamma jivanti loma vilaja jagadanna natha. Vishnu mahansa iva jasya kalavisesho govinda madhikul samutavam. That Mahavishnu is lying on the causal ocean beyond this universe, on the border. There is a big ocean which is called causal ocean, karanadakjal. There is Mahavishnu lying, and from his breathing process, jasyaika nishyasita kalam athavalamba, jivanti loma vilaja jagadannanatha. Jagadannanatha means Brahma. So, that portion, ekappasu rasayakam, is the origin of universal, this material creation. Karunanamsai Vishnu. From him, the Garbhodaksai Vishnu comes out and he enters in each and every universe. Garbhodaksai Vishnu. That Garbhodaksai Vishnu again expands as Kirodaksai Vishnu. That Kirodaksai Vishnu is within this universe. In each and every universe, there is Vishnu. Shape of the loka, where Kirodaksai Vishnu is there, and that Kirodaksai Vishnu enters within the heart of all living entities, Paramatma, Antarjyani. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Ekappasu rachayatam jagadanna koti jachatti rasti jagadanna chaya ananta. Andantarastha, he is not only within this universe, but he is also within the atom. Annantarastham paramanu chayam. Paramanu means atom. In this way, Lord Vishnu is expanded and he is given. He is to be understood. Gyan, knowledge, simply material knowledge is not perfection of knowledge. Real knowledge is to understand the Supreme Absolute Truth, Vishnu. That is real knowledge. That is explained here, Giyam Jattat Prabhakshani. I shall now explain to you what is the ultimate goal of knowledge. In other place, in the 15th chapter also, Krishna said, Sarvasya chaham vivishanna vishta matta smritijnanam apohanam cha vedaishya sarvai aham eva vedyam. Krishna is within everyone's heart. Sarvasya cha aham ridhi. This place, the particular place is also mentioned there, ridhi, in the heart. Is there. Sannivishta. And from him, matta smriti jnanam apuhanancha. From him, our remembrance, smriti, jnana, knowledge, and forgetfulness, everything is coming from him. Matta smriti jnanam apuhanancha. Therefore, vedaishta sadvai aham eva vedyam. One has to understand Krishna by studying Vedic literature. If he is missing Krishna, then Sarvayeva, he kevalam. He is missing Krishna. That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Dharmasthanu sthitapvamsan vishakshena kathasuja nutpadayadratin jadi Sarvayeva, he kevalam. Everyone has got particular type of occupational duty. That is called dharma. Dharma is not a faith. The particular duty, just like you are a medical practitioner, so your dharma is to treat patients. That is your dharma. So, everyone has got particular occupation and duty. Actually, what is going on as Hindu dharma, actually Hindu dharma, this word, is not there in the shastras. In the shastra, it is called varnasram dharma. Four varnas, Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra, and four ashramas, brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, and sannyas. These are called varnasram dharma. So, in every varna, Brahman, his qualification is described in the shastra. Sama, dama, siddhikha, arjava, kanti, jnanam, vijnanam, astikam, brahma, karma, sabhava. Similarly, kshatriya, vaishya. So, by discharging one's occupational duty according to varna and ashrama, if one does not understand Krishna, the Bhagavad says, Sramaniva hi kevalam, then he is simply spoiling his time and wasting his labor, that's all. Dharma sana sthita pumsana vishakshina kathasuja, not parayana tingyari, Sramaniva hi kevalam. This is the verdict of the Vikritas. He is simply laboring for nothing. One must know Krishna, Vishakshina Kathasura. Vishakshina, another name of Krishna, Vishnu, is Vishakshina, Katha. That's why you are speaking about Krishna. Nobody is interested to come here. Nobody is interested. Vishakshina Kathasura, now Father is looking. They will say, I am busy with my occupational duty. But the human form of life is meant for increasing your interest in the matter of Vishakshina Kathasu. This means Krishna Katha. This is the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya, his mission is this. He said, Amar Agnaya Guru Hoya. Taro ei desh, jare dakho tare koho Krishna upadesh. Krishna upadesh. He said, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that on my order, every one of my devotee become a spiritual master. Amar Agnaya Guru Haiya. Taro sarvadesh. You become a spiritual master and deliver all the people. Like with Krishna upadesh, you can deliver. People are suffering. Here is the same thing is said. Geyam jat parvakshami jat gatya amritam asmute. Amritam. People are suffering, they do not know what is amritatta. So amritattaya kalpate. This is the aim of life. To become immortal. That is wanted. One has to come to that platform of knowledge when one can achieve the perfection of life, amritatta, immortality. So Krishna says here that Gyan Dattar Prabhakshan, the ultimate goal of knowledge, I will explain to you. Jajgatta, if you can understand that knowledge, then Amritam Asrate, if anyone can understand that knowledge, he becomes immortal. That is the problem. The process of knowledge, in that chapter, It is already said that janma mrityu jara vyadhi dukkha dosha anudarshan. The subject matter should be how to understand or how to get relief from the repetition of birth and death, old age and disease. This is knowledge. And here also, Krishna says again, anyone who comes to the ultimate goal of knowledge, then he becomes immortal. Anadi mat param brahma. Brahma, brahma jnan. The brahma jnan without knowledge of Krishna is not perfect knowledge. Generally, people are interested in the impersonal brahma. But without knowledge of Krishna, that impersonal feature of Krishna, brahma jnan, is also insufficient. They do not, that is not sufficient knowledge. Tattva jnanartha darsana, philosophical speculation or discussion should be to reach the ultimate goal of life. Tattva jnanartha darsana, that is already explained. And what is that tattva? That is explained in the Srimad Bhagavatam. What is tattva? Vadanti tattva vidas tattvam. Tattva be, one who knows tattva, he can speak about tattva. Tattva means the absolute truth. So vadanti tattva vidas tattvam. That thing is spoken as tattva, as the truth, by persons who are tattva-vit. Tattva-vit means one who knows the tattva. Unless one knows the thing, how he can explain? Therefore, we have to understand the absolute truth from a person who knows it. Vadanti tattva-vidas tattvam. Jadgyanam advayam. That knowledge is absolute, advayam, no relativity, absolute. Vadanti tattva-vidas tattvam jadgyanam advayam. Brahmeti, Paramatmiti, Bhagavaniti, Sabdate. That truth is explained as Brahma, as Paramatma, or as Bhagavan. The same thing. That's like we see the sun. The sun is a planet, and there is a sun god. Just like we have God also in each and every planet, one chief person. Here we have got president. Formerly there was one president or king on this planet. Now there are now so many presidents. But according to God's plan, there is one president or king in each and every planet. So in the sun planet, there is also one king, or one chief person. His name is also given in the Bhagavad Gita, Vivashyam. If you accept Bhagavad Gita, then you have to accept all these things. You cannot make minus anything. That is not knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. That's what you are presenting, Bhagavad Gita as it is. We cannot use the ardha-kukruti in that. Half, I take half of the hem, I take the rear part and the front part I reject. This kind of logic, argument will not be very successful. You have to take as it is, total, and you have to understand. That is understanding of Bhagavad Gita. If you take something to your choice, and that is useless waste of time. That's why Mahatma Gandhi, he wanted to prove from Bhagavad Gita, non-violence. Yeah, how is it possible? Bhagavad Gita is spoken in the battlefield. So in this way, if we try to understand Bhagavad Gita, it will be not Bhagavad Gita, it will be something else. We must understand Bhagavad Gita as it is. That is our preaching method. We are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is all over the world. So we accept. The modern theory, scientific theory is that the sun planet is only blazing fire. There cannot be any living entity. No, we don't believe that. Because Shastra says that the living entity is never born. Achyadyam adajyam. Adajyam. Just like we sterilize by putting into the fire. But that does not mean the living entity is dead. No. Adajyam. It cannot be burnt into fire. Achyadyam. It cannot be cut into pieces. This information I get from Bhagavad Gita. So, in the sun planet, although it is blazing fire, they are living entities. They have got a particular type of body. That particular type of body is fiery. Just like you have got living entities in the sea, there are hundreds and thousands. Jalaja Anamulakhani. There are 9 lakh species of aquatic animals. But they are living in the water. They have got particular type of body. You cannot say, because you cannot live within the water, you cannot say, no, no, there cannot be any living. This is nonsense. The living entities, another name is Sarvago. He can live everywhere. It is not a fact the living entity lives only in certain particular place. No, Sarvago. Anywhere in God's creation, there are living entities. This is Shastric vision. So, in the sun planet also, there are living entities, cities, just like here. Otherwise, how Krishna can say, Imam Vivasati Rupam Pratyaman Ahamabhayam. Krishna is telling life that I spoke this science of Bhagavad Gita to the sun god. Now according to our calculation, nobody can go to the sun planet and where is the scope of speaking there and to whom speaking. But Krishna says, yes, imam vivasati rūvam pratyaha aham. I said, abhayam, imperishable. Knowledge. Vimushan manabhi prahu. So, from this verse we can understand in the sun planet there are living entities and the chief man or chief demigod is the sun god whose name is Vimushan. So his body must be fiery, otherwise how he can live there? And the inhabitants there also. So, we are thinking from here that nobody can live there, but that's not the fact. We are calculating by our own experience. Therefore, we cannot have perfect knowledge by speculating our experience. It is not possible. We must go to a person whose experience is beyond our experience. That is called Guru. Pratvijnanartham sa Guru meva vigacchati. Guru means heavy. If Guru is as good as I am, then what is the use of taking knowledge from him? Guru must be heavy. So who can become more heavier than Krishna? Matta paratanam nanya kinti jasti ghananjaya. There is nobody heavier. And Krishna, when he was a child, when he was a boy, 7 years old, he proved how heavy that he lifted the Govardhan peak. And he rested on Krishna's finger continually for 7 days. Just imagine how heavy he is. So in this way we have to understand Krishna. And if we understand Krishna from that spirit, from that angle of vision, then we become perfect. As it is said here, Giyam Datta Parvakshami Jadgatya Amritamasnate, you become immortal. This is confirmed in the fourth chapter. Janma Karmam Vibhvam Jujanati Tattva. If you simply understand Krishna in truth, not superficial, but in fact, then what is there? The result is tapta deham punarjanma nayati. Punarjanma. Punarjanma next. Again, if I take a material body, then again I will have to die. Anyone who has got this material body, he has to die. Janma mithya. One who is born, he must die. But here, Krishna says, punarjanma nayati. Never birth. Then there is no more death. Because if there is birth, there is death. And if there is no birth, there is no death. That is immortality, amrita. That is amritatva. So amritattaya kalpate. In another place Krishna says, janhina badhante te purusam purusarasava. Samas sukham dukham bhira. So amritattaya kalpate. We are disturbed by the bodily conscious of life, every one of us. Everyone is busy. How to relieve the bodily pains and pleasure? That's all. The real pains and pleasure that the living entity was accepted this material body. He has to continue this pains and pleasure. That is explained in the Bhagavad. Janma mithya jarabhyadi. So there is no science to give relief from janma mithya jarabhyadi. So how you can expect relief? It is temporary relief. So Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, we should not be disturbed by the temporary pains and pleasures. Matras parsastu kuntiya sitosna sukhadukkhada agama apayina anityatana tithikhasabhara. We do not be disturbed by these so-called bodily pains and pleasures. We can try, we can get as much, but this is not our business. Our business is how to get out of these clutches of birth and death. That is their business. That they do not. Because they have no knowledge. All fools and rascals, they are busy for the temporary pains and pleasures. Yes. So here it is said, Gyam Jatta Prabhakshani, Jad Jatta Amritam Asnati. That is knowledge. I shall speak to you about that supreme knowledge. That supreme knowledge means, if you simply try to understand Krishna, Janma Karma Medibham, why Krishna appears? Janma Karma. Why he was like an ordinary human being? He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Why he takes part in these ordinary activities? That's why Krishna took part in the battle of Kurukshetra. So he is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Why should he take part in the battle? Yes, this is somebody, some section of people, they posted like this. But he has his business. Because he comes, he has got his business. He said, Dharma samasthapana kaya sambhavani jiri. I come. My business is to re-establish the principle of life, religion. Human life means religion. Dharmena hina pasubi samana. The cats and dogs, they have no religion. But if the human being has no religion, then he is no better than the cat and dog. Therefore, all over the world, either he is a European or American or Indian or Canadian or Russian, everyone has got some religion. It doesn't matter whether it is Hinduism, Muslimism or Christianism. Because human society without religious conception. Religious conception means to understand God. His animal. Dharmena hina pasuvi samana. Gradually the whole world is becoming animal because they are rejecting religion. They are rejecting religion. Therefore Krishna says, dharma samasthapunarthaya sambhavani jivedi. Because these rascals, they give up religion and become animals and fight within themselves and make the whole world a confusion and chaos. Therefore, it is required that Krishna comes, dharma samasthapunarthaya. This is his duty. He has no duty, but it is his mercy that it comes. Dharma samasthapunartha. And what is that dharma? In the Bhagavad it is explained, dharmantu sakshat bhagavat pranitam. He cannot manufacture a religious sect. That is asked. That's why you think, I shall manufacture law at my home. Is it possible? Who cares for your law? If the law is enacted by the state, that is accepted. The government says, keep to the left, you have to accept it. You cannot say, no, why not, to the right, then you will be criminal. Similarly, laws means given by the government. And dharma means which is the course given by God. That is dharma. Dharmantu sāsād bhagavat pranā. That is religion. And Krishna says, dharma samasthapunārthāya sambhavāni jivedi. I come to re-establish when people become cats and dogs without any religion. Then I come down to establish religion. Because we are Krishna's sons, we are all sons of Krishna. He is very much anxious to see us happy, just like father wants to see his sons, bewildered sons, to see that he is happy. Paritranaya sadhanam vinashaya cha duskritam. That is also the same thing. To deliver the righteous person and to kill the demons, the same thing. Because Krishna is absolute. He is maintaining the devotee and killing the demons. Both of them are same thing, just like father. Father is giving some child, some son, nice sweet meat. And the other son comes, no, you cannot take it. Does it mean that father is partial? No, father is kind, both the child. He knows that he cannot eat. So similarly, two things are going on, parallel. Some are punishments, some are maintenance by the laws of God. But he knows how to do it. We have to accept his law, that is, tattenukampasasumiksamana. Therefore, devotee is never disturbed by the so-called pains and pleasures of this world. He's never disturbed. He who knows his duty, how to execute Krishna consciousness. That is real devotee. Sarva-dhanmān parityajya māmekam. So Krishna said that dharma samasthapunārthāya sambhavāni jude-jude. Then what is that dharma? He did not come here to re-establish Hinduism or Muslimism or Christianism. No. He came to give you real dharma. What is that? Sarva-dhanmān parityajya māmekam sarva-dhanmān. That is dharma. To surrender unto Krishna. Krishna, I am eternally your servant. I forgot you. Now I come to my senses. I surrender unto you. This is dharma. Maunam janunavante jnanavan maana prabhadvati. This sense, real sense comes when after struggling for many births, one becomes wise. Maunam janunavante jnanavan. Jnanavan means wise, not fools and rascals. Janavan, Mana Prabhupada, surrenders unto me. So, anyone who is surrendering to Krishna, taking to Krishna devotional service fully, he is the most intelligent man. He is not cats and dogs or rascals. Because Krishna says, Janavan, this is your knowledge. That is explained. Krishna says, Gyan Jatta Prabhakshami. I shall speak to you what is the object of knowledge, ultimate objective of knowledge. Jagratya Amritamasmati. If one can understand Krishna, he gets eternal life. And that is our aim of life. Not to remain within this material world. Bhutta bhutta praliyate. Take birth once and again die. This is done by the cats and dogs. Any animal, they do not know anything. They take birth and again die. Dehinasmindhadehi kumbhanajobunanjala tatha dehantara prati. You have to accept. So if in ignorance I take birth and again die, what is this like? Bhutta bhutta praliyate. That is no knowledge. Spoiling. This is human form of life. Is the boom where you can make a solution. Simply by understanding Krishna. Janma tanma medibbam jujanatita praptadhi hankunan janma naiti. This is knowledge. How to become immortal, how to understand Krishna, how to go back to home, back to Godhead. That is the mission of Krishna consciousness. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.